My name is Frank Yang. I've been working at the Laboratory for Skeletal Regeneration for 3 years, and I have a BA in physiology. My specific area of research will be bone regeneration, specifically the role of muscle stem cells during fracture repair. As we know, when we break our bones, have any sort of trauma, we want to try to fix that as soon as possible and without any complications. And what that entails really is just a number of processes in your body coordinating and having a sort of concerted effort towards this ultimate goal of restoring function, having regeneration. And from those different factors, I'm studying the role of surrounding musculature, specifically satellite cells, which are the stem cells that give rise to new muscle fiber and could also potentially have other different roles. So I'm really just looking at essentially one pathway that's feeding into this whole effort of regenerating bone as well as regenerating soft tissue so that you can once again be functional. I was actually very scientifically minded as another child. I got really lucky and I was really privileged in that both of my parents were doctors back in China, and I immigrated here when I was 4. And then from there, sort of the like little seed of science was planted in me. My elementary school was literally 6 or 7 blocks away from the UCSF Parnassus campus, and because my parents worked there, I was able to actually kind of sneak into their lab setting, kind of actually be where I am today. But as you know, just a, like a little tyke, just running around as like however old I was, like 8 or 9, that was just something that was very novel, very interesting to me, and sort of just took off from there. I like think UCSF is #1 hospital in the world. I mean, it's a great place to work. It's sort of an understatement to say that a lot of bright minds have come through UCSF. And just with the resources that the school has, it opens a lot of doors, especially in science. No matter what you want to dabble in, there's, you know, many branches you can take. And working at UCSF really helps to facilitate where you want to be, in my opinion. As adults, we can heal only up to a certain extent. Where we're not like all these other newts or like animals where if they have, say, a tail grabbed by a predator, they can just shed it off and then it grows back again. As human adults, we're really limited in what we can regenerate. But bone and soft tissue are sort of the two that are very capable, very able to regenerate back to almost the original state. It's kind of like if we were to break a bone, we put it in a cast, we would wait, and hopefully everything will be back normal and functioning 100%. And in 99% of cases, this is true, and this is very unique. But in those like 1% or even higher chance that something does go wrong, can we find some factor, find that, what's in that like magic black box that will return us that 100% again in those cases? As a scientist, it's a lot of data collection. And what that really entails is doing experiments, doing diagnostics, running tests. If we think that chemical A causes this response, we're going to look at chemical A in the context of all these different tests so that we can build evidence for it. So my day pretty much comes down to running all these tests, interpreting all my numbers, and sort of like planting trees so I can see the forest of what I'm going for. The mark that I would want to leave would just be any mark, because the way that research works, it's almost like my contributions are drops in a bucket. It's not in a bad way, because a lot of times when people say, oh, it's only a drop in the bucket, it's very insignificant. But as one person researching one project on one aspect of such a complicated biological process, you really have to think that it's gotta be collaboration. It's gotta be a huge worldwide collaborative effort, and you're contributing just that little bit, which might allow someone else to push a little more, and then someone else pushes a little more, a little more, and a little more, and eventually your little, you know, seemingly drop in the bucket could pave the way for some revolutionary just procedure, just something that would change the way people think about this field.